Set out for Australia. 'Twas a cold winter's day long ago. On board was a young Irish colleen, the grief on her features did show. A priest offered deep consolation, and he spoke of the bright days ahead. When she woke from her sad meditation, and these are the words that she said: I love the green field by the quarry, the field where the red clovers grow, the waterfall sounding above it, and the heather-clad mountain below. That lovely green field by the quarry, every step of my childhood has known. The clear crystal spring in the corner, and that little thatch dwelling my home. Now the ship, it has sailed o'er the water. She is now on Australia's broad plains, and she thinks of the brave Irish patriots who labored as convicts in vain. She sees the green field by the quarry, in her vision old Ireland appears, and she prays for her gallant forefathers who held it through torture and tears. Now the years, they roll onward forever. She's a wife and a mother once more, and she sings to the child on her bosom the songs of old Erin's green shore. Her brother has left the old homestead, setting fears and afflictions aflow. And she pleads in a letter she's writing, and these are the words that she wrote: don't sell the green field by the quarry, every step of my childhood delights, for the vision that haunted my dreaming on my dear mice's pillow at night. Don't sell the green field by the quarry, no matter wherever I roam. While you own that green field by the quarry, I feel that my heart has. Now the home of her heart is still calling. Again she revisits the scene, the laughter of children is lovely, and the field by the quarry is green. Don't sell the green field by the quarry, no matter wherever I roam. While you own that green field by the quarry, I feel that my heart has a home.
Thank you very much.